take a quick glance at the fastest growing trends on the web, or twens on the web, as I say, you'll know that podcasts probably the number one story these days. Problem is, though, unlike a web page, it's not easy to find content inside a podcast because it's pure audio. Well, if you're looking for audio content, Podzinger is the solution. Alex Latz is here from Podzinger to explain how they have transformed podcasting. Alex, it's great to meet you in person. We've talked before.
Likewise.
On a podcast. You're with BBN.
Yes, I am.
BBN is an amazing story. Bolt, Baranek, and Newman. It started out a long time, like the 40s, right?
1948.
And the original company was not, had nothing to do with technology.
No. Well, yes, it did. It was you know, physicists.
Yeah, engineering.
And so that's technology.
I guess so. In its day, it was technology.
The first project was the acoustic design for the UN General Assembly.
Right, it was sound design.
That's right.
Which is a neat thing.
It's very cool.
At one point, they got a contract from the Defense Department to design this thing, this kind of network of computers. This was in the 60s.
Yeah, this thing.
Yeah, this thing, which became the Internet.
Exactly.
Which is pretty amazing. BBN is still around, still very active in engineering and consultancy, and one of the spin-off projects from BBN is this Podzinger.
That's correct.
Yeah, that's pretty neat. Did you come in as part of Podzinger, or have you been with BBN for a long time?
I've been with BBN for not a long time in BBN standards. I've been with BBN since 2004.
Right.
And Podzinger is our first spin-out company that we've created as part of my team at BBN.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
So you're kind of germinating other ideas?
We have a few different things, you know, going on.
Yeah.
Some very different than Podzinger,
oh,
for sure.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. Well, tell us how the idea for Podzinger came about.
Well, the idea came about from the fact that it actually goes back to around late 90s, 98, when the issue of looking for and searching for multimedia content, broadcast and telephone content,
right,
came about. But it wasn't.
This wasn't a contract from the NSA, was it?
Actually, if you know,
was it a government contract?
It's a government contract. This is all government sponsored. In fact, after 9/11. For 3 years, BBN led the research program to really turn this into reality.
How interesting. So what we're seeing here is technology that was originally used to analyze phone calls, basically.
Phone calls and broadcast TV. We support Arabic. We support Mandarin Chinese.
How interesting. Yeah. Well, if you think about it, now, if you're a spy and you want to gather information, what better way than to monitor a country's broadcasts?
That's right.
But you need some help if you're going to monitor thousands of these, and this is the kind of software you develop. So is it actually understanding the text?
There's actually some part of just pure speech to text. It takes the words that we speak and turns them into text-based words,
right,
so that we can then search them with any search technology.
That's a hard thing to do. As we know, anybody who's used Drag and Dictate or any kind of voice dictation software, computers are not great at understanding what we're saying.
Yeah, and even we aren't that great sometimes.
No, that's right.
What we say. But we're smart enough to kind of understand the context. This also understands some of that context because it is trained around the words as they appear with other words.
Oh, so it does look at the context of the word.
That's right.
Interesting.
That's right. So what you can do then is, you know, what it really ends up doing is it takes what is otherwise unsearchable black space and makes it into fully searchable, you know, clear and obvious space.
It's text.
As text. That's right.
And you don't have to get every word. If you get the kind of main words, that's what you're really looking for, right?
That's exactly the case. Most of the words that we care about are repeated several times during the course of a discussion.
It's not and, the, but, well, I.
Right, right.
It's nouns. It's
exactly.
Yeah.
So the non-meaning words, you know, you can mess those up. And frankly, sometimes you can even mess up some of the words that we really care about. The key here is that speech recognition will probably never be perfect, just as humans aren't perfect at it. Computers won't be perfect at it. But for searching for those words and finding content that we otherwise wouldn't be able to find, that's a great application. So we realized, hey, with the emergence of online multimedia content, and then last summer with Apple's little nudge, we moved into kind of a broader world of podcasting.
Right.
We said, we have to bring this technology to this market. It's the perfect market for it because this content is otherwise undiscoverable.
It's opaque, as you say.
That's right.
You can't see what's in it. On the other hand, doing this is very processor intensive. There's a lot of work involved.
Right.
There are, at last count, well over 20,000 podcasts. You can't possibly do them all.
We actually are motivated to do them all.
Really?
Yeah. And
wow.
Then go beyond that, actually.
We'd so like you have to, a big farm of servers somewhere doing this?
We have a farm of servers. The hardest part and the biggest investment really was in the research it took to figure out how to do this in the first place. The computers are pretty inexpensive by
yeah, I guess
comparison.
They are. Yeah.
And so we're highly motivated. You know, we're on our way. We're at 221,000 podcasts as of this moment.
And that's episodes
of podcasts.
Wow.
And moving up. And we are motivated to kind of cover the world of podcasts. And I think once we've got that covered, then we'll start to say, okay, well, there's more audio and video on the web as well to start to add to this. Let's make it all discoverable in this kind of way.
Yeah, you haven't done anything until you go to YouTube and try to index that stuff.
That's a very different category.
That's a lot of work.
That's right.
And so now somebody can go to podzinger.com.
That's right.
Just as you would with Google, there's a field. You enter in a search term.
That's right.
What I like about it is it doesn't merely say, oh, here's the podcast it appeared in. It actually puts a player up. Queued up to that point of the podcast.
That's right. And
I'll
show a screen here. I did a just to save a little time. I did a search on Xbox in Podzinger, and as you'd expect, there are many, many results. 3,260 different results. But what we do is we allow you to actually see what we call the snippets around the term Xbox as they occurred in the audio
so
or the video.
So you get both the transcript and a player.
That's right. Yeah. So here in this first case, this is the cheat video podcast that helps gamers learn how to and play and defeat games. Here's where the Xbox is actually referred in that segment. And then as you see, as I scroll across each of these words, they're all linked. And that's because we actually know the timestamp of every word as it occurred in that particular segment of the video. In this particular piece of video, it occurred at 16 seconds in, so it was relatively close. But I jumped down here into the Xbox 360 podcast, and the piece I care about might be down here at 5 minutes 25 seconds.
You don't want to have to listen to that whole 5 minutes. You can go right to 5:25 and say, here, let's listen.
So it's what kind of people who first get exposed to this, it's the access that knocks their socks off, because you don't get that access with Google for text.
No.
When you search in Google for text, you don't go exactly to the location in the text. It just tells you somewhere in there is a search term.
No, that's right.
And here, we take you right to that place. And
that's really neat.
Most people play in Podzinger.
You find that's what happens? People click right there?
They play, and then they download or subscribe, and we make that kind of one button doable.
So it's really good news for podcasters, too, because it means people can now find what you're talking about.
Right.
Otherwise, they'd have to rely on show notes or your blog or whatever it is when you talk about it in text.
Right.
This way they can actually find it in the
They can find it. And then what we really encourage podcasters to do as well is, in areas that they talk frequently about, we encourage them to save their results as RSS feeds, because every search is a live search.
Right.
And they can post that into their blog, and then that all the text from that search result is searchable from all the search engines.
So in my podcast, Twit, we use find where we talked about Microsoft. I could make that be a feed.
Yep.
You click a button, you'd get every time Microsoft was mentioned in a Twit podcast,
exactly.
all 60 of them.
Exactly.
Wow.
Yeah. So
very
that
cool.
A lot of people are more and more people are doing that every day, and that's kind of taking its own little life, because RSS has its own life.
Yeah. And oh, so, yeah, it does. Yeah.
And so we're just bringing the words from the audio and the video into this domain so that podcasters can get discovered, so that they can make their content more easily found.
You still have that government contract?
Oh, actually, the government contract transitioned into an even fancier government contract, which involves translation of languages as well, so that you can then, if you're an English speaker, you can someday you'll be able to kind of listen to Japanese podcasts and search in English for those.
Simultaneous translation.
It's in the future.
Yeah, pretty amazing.
Yeah,
but I will be the last person to say it's too far in the future, because when the BBN's involved, it's pretty amazing what they do. Yeah. Alex Latz is the CEO of Podzinger. You can find out more about his company, of course, and do your own searches at podzinger.com.